Welcome back for another example on how to solve a rational equation. In this video, we'll solve the equation by first building fractions that have the same least common denominator. Step two, then we're going to multiply each fraction by the common denominator to clear the fractions from the equation, solve, and check. So before we build fractions that contain the least common denominator, we want to start by factoring all the denominators. So for our first fraction, we have the quantity x plus 1 divided by x squared plus 2x. These two terms have a factor of x
in common.
So we factor x out. We're left with the quantity x plus 2. For the next fraction, we have the quantity x plus 4 divided by the quantity x squared plus x. Again, these two terms have a common factor of x. So we'll factor x out, leaving us with the quantity x plus 1. And then on the right side, notice how we have negative 3 divided by the quantity x squared plus 3x plus 2, which factors into two binomial factors. We have x and x. The factors of positive 2 that add to positive 3 are positive 2 and positive 1. Before we rewrite each fraction with the least common denominator, let's talk about the excluded values for this equation. We must exclude the values of x that would produce division by 0. Looking at this first fraction, notice if x is equal to 0 here, we'd have division by 0. So we have to exclude x equals 0. But also negative 2 would produce a 0 in the denominator, so x also can't equal negative 2. Looking at the second fraction, notice how we've already excluded 0, but we also must exclude negative 1. And then for the third fraction, we've already excluded negative 2 and negative 1. Now the next thing we should notice is that our least common denominator, or LCD, will have to contain one factor of x, one factor of x plus 2, and one factor of x plus 1. So looking at this first fraction, notice how the denominator is missing a factor of x plus 1. So we're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by the quantity x plus 1. Let's also put our original numerators in parentheses here and here. Notice for the second fraction, the denominator is missing a factor of x plus 2. So we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by the quantity x plus 2. And then finally on the right side, this fraction is missing a factor of x in the denominator. So we're going to multiply the numerator and denominator by x. Now that each fraction has the least common denominator, we're going to clear the fractions by multiplying both sides of the equation by the LCD, which means we're going to multiply the left side of the equation by x, x plus 2, and x plus 1, all over 1 if we want, and the same thing on the right side. X times the quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x plus 1. Notice for each product, we're going to have a factor of x over x. This simplifies to 1. We'll have a factor of x plus 2 over x plus 2, which simplifies to 1. And we'll also have a factor of x plus 1 over x plus 1, simplifying to 1, and therefore clearing the fractions from the equation. So this first product would just leave us with the quantity x plus 1 times the quantity x plus 1. The second product would just leave us with minus the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity x plus 2. And on the right side, everything simplifies out except negative 3x. Notice this equation here is just the numerators of the fractions once we obtained the least common denominator. Now we'll clear the parentheses and solve for x. So we'll have four products here and four products here. So we'll have x times x, that's x squared. X times 1 is 1x, plus 1 times x, that's another 1x, so that's plus 2x, plus 1. Minus x times x is x squared. Then we have x times 2, that's 2x. And then 4 times x, that's 4x, so plus 6x. And then plus 8 equals negative 3x. And now we'll clear these parentheses. We can think of distributing 1 here and distributing negative 1 here because of the minus. So we'll have x squared plus 2x plus 1. And then minus x squared minus 6x minus 8. Now combining like terms on the left side, notice that x squared minus x squared, that'd be 0. Then we have 2x minus 6x, that's negative 4x. And then 1 minus 8 is negative 7, or minus 7 equals negative 3x. Let's go ahead and add 4x to both sides of the equation. So we have negative 7 equals x. Well, negative 7 is not one of the excluded values, and therefore our solution is x equals negative 7. Okay, that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.